Hi, you're watching the IT Taster channel. I'm John, and in this session, I'm going to go through password policies which form part of account policy enforcement in the CompTIA Security Plus certification. And I'll finish off by demonstrating how to implement a password policy in Windows Server 2016 using group policy. So by the end of the session, you'll have an understanding of password best practices relating to strength, complexity, length, expiration, history, and reuse. And you'll be able to configure a password policy in Windows Server 2016 using group policy in your test lab. Before we begin the session, I just wanted to say that your engagement and feedback is really important to me and really useful. So please give the session a thumbs up if you liked it and drop a comment below. Say hi and let me know your experiences because it's always good to hear from you. And don't forget to subscribe to the IT Taster channel and hit the notification bell to receive new content alerts. Okay, so let's go over to the training session. The most common method used to verify an individual's identity is the use of a secret password. And in order to maintain network security, we need to ensure that network users are following best practices when it comes to passwords. This is something that involves educating users and enforcing by technical means. Now, best practices recommend the use of strong passwords. A strong password shouldn't be easily guessable or contain things like the user's name or account name, for example. It's also important to avoid words found in the dictionary to prevent passwords from being guessed or exploited by freely available password cracking tools. Password cracking tools are able to perform things like dictionary attacks, for example, which involve using a list of words found in the dictionary. Passwords should also be as long as possible, typically around 14 characters in length. This helps to protect against brute force attacks that work their way through every combination of characters. And passwords should be complex. They should contain a combination of capital and lowercase characters from A through to Z, numbers 0 through to 9, and special characters, sometimes referred to as symbols, such as exclamation marks, dollar signs, and hashes, etc. Complexity helps to prevent both brute force attacks and dictionary attacks. A password expiry age requires users to change their password after a set time. In Windows Server 2016, the default is 42 days. The longer a password is in use, the more likely it is to be discovered. So changing passwords regularly helps to minimize the risk of discovery, and also the possible impact if a password is discovered. Now, when configuring a password expiry age, it's important to be aware that if users are required to change their passwords too frequently, it can generate a lot of support calls at the help desk. It's also important to manage the reuse of passwords. Password history specifies the number of new, unique passwords a user must have used before they're able to reuse an old password. Reusing old passwords increases the risk of discovery, of course, or that old password may have been discovered already. And a couple of additional points to mention. Long, complex passwords, as we've discussed, do indeed increase security. However, making passwords too long and too complex can be counterproductive, resulting in users doing things like writing their password on bits of paper because they're unable to remember them. And finally, if users suspect their passwords have been compromised, they must report it immediately. So let's go over to the server and take a look at how to configure a password policy in group policy in Windows Server 2016. I've logged into my test server in the test lab and I'm currently in server manager. So to edit a password policy in group policy, I need to click tools and click group policy management. And in group policy management, once it loads up, we need to expand the forest and expand domains. Now here you'll notice my forest root domain is called ittaster.local. .local domain names are usually known as internal or dummy domain names. Now it's okay in most cases to use these in a lab environment, but it's certainly not a good idea to use them in production networks. So I'm going to expand my ittaster.local domain name, and here we can see the default domain policy. Now the default domain policy applies to all computers and users within the domain. So it's a good idea to make as few adjustments to this policy as possible. Normally when configuring group policies, we tend to create organizational units and then create separate group policies and apply them to those organizational units. So to edit the default domain policy, we need to right click it and choose edit. And here we can see the computer configuration policies and preferences and the user configuration policies and preferences. I'm going to expand the computer configuration policies and click Windows Settings. And Security Settings. Let's just make that a little bit wider so that we can see what we're doing. And I'm going to expand account policies and click on password policy. And that's what we're interested in. Now the first policy I'm interested in taking a look at is the password must meet complexity requirements. Now to edit a policy, you can either double click on it or right click the policy and choose properties. Now this is a pretty straightforward policy. We either enable it or disable it. But as with any group policy, if we click the Explain tab, it gives us a really detailed explanation of what the policy does. It tells us that our password must be at least 6 characters in length, and it must contain characters from 3 of the following 4 categories. Uppercase and lowercase characters A through to Z, our digits 0 through to 9, and our non-alphabetical characters. We don't need to make any changes here, so I'm going to click OK. The next policy I want to take a look at is the minimum password length. So I'll right click on that and choose properties. And here we can see that the minimum password length is currently set to 7 characters. Now if we click the Explain tab, this tells us that this security setting determines the least number of characters that a password for a user account may contain. And we can set it to a value between 1 and 14 characters. It also says that we can establish that no password is required by setting the number of characters to 0. But of course, that's not something we want to do. So I'm going to set the password to 14 characters. And click OK. The next policy I want to take a look at is the maximum password age. This is currently set at 42 days. And again, if we click the Explanation tab, it tells us that this security setting determines the period of time in days that a password can be used before the system requires the user to change it. Now, I'm quite happy with the default of 42 days, so I'm simply going to click OK. Next policy I want to look at is Enforce Password History. And if we click the Explain tab, this tells us that this security setting determines the number of unique new passwords that have to be associated with a user account before an old password can be reused. And the value must be between 0 and 24 passwords. And again, I'm quite happy with the default of 24 passwords, so I'm going to click OK. The minimum password age policy works hand in hand with password history. Now the minimum password age is currently set at 1 day. And if we click the Explain tab, it tells us that this security setting determines the period of time in days that a password must be used before the user can change it. And we can set it to a value between 1 and 998 days. Now, if we set this policy setting to 0, it effectively disables it, and it means that the user can change their password immediately. And that can work against password history because it means a user could, in theory, cycle through 24 new unique passwords and then go back to using reusing an old password, which is not something that we want to do. So I'm going to leave this policy setting as it is with the default of 1 day and click OK. Our last policy setting to talk about is store passwords using reversible encryption. And you'll notice that this policy is set as disabled. And if we click the Explain tab, there's a really good reason for that. If we look down here, it says that storing passwords using reversible encryption is essentially the same as storing plain text versions of the passwords. And for this reason, this policy should never be enabled unless application requirements outweigh the need to protect password information. So obviously, I'm going to leave this policy set as disabled and click OK. Well, that brings us to the end of the session. Hope you found it helpful and hopefully it's given you a better idea of how password policies relate to both Security Plus and also Windows Server 2016. If you did enjoy the video, please give it a thumbs up and drop a comment below because your comments and feedback are really important to me. They help me evaluate how well my videos are doing and also improve future content. And don't forget, please subscribe to the IT Taster channel if you haven't already. Hit the notification bell to receive alerts of new content. And I'm also around on social media, so it's good to hear from you there too. Well, that's it from me. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.